It's April 17th. I have about 80 luffa plants here. I planted 3 seeds per pot, about 3/4 of an inch deep. We had a little spell of cold weather there a week or so ago, and it got my germinating room down below 70 again. Same thing happened to me last year. So I moved them, set them in a warm place. Been sitting them outside here in the sun the last week or so. They've really started coming out now. Just need to keep them alive and transplant them here in a couple weeks. It's the 19th of June. Several of my plants are about 3 feet long. 3 to 4. They're still running behind, but the hot weather's helping. They're growing really well. This one here's got a little tiny luffa on it already. It bloomed a little too soon. The vine's not very long yet, but they're progressing. It's just slow and behind schedule. This is about a 4-foot vine, 5-foot maybe. It's curled around here. Growing on my trellis. So far, I give them a little fish-based fertilizer when they're in the pot still. It's mostly nitrogen. When I transplanted, I used about a tablespoon of blood meal. That's kept them fairly green looking. And now that they're getting bigger, I'll give them a little more phosphate and potash. Give them some more general purpose type fertilizer, which will encourage a little more blooming. You don't really want them to bloom until they're big enough to support the flowers and the fruits. There's a nice little bud forming right there. So yeah, they're behind schedule. They should be a little bit longer than this by now. But the weather's hot. As long as I keep them watered, they should keep growing. It's the 26th of June. The weather's been hot. We're getting enough rain now. I had a while there where I wasn't getting enough rain, and I had to water them several times. Got a little bit of insect damage. They're nice and green. The blood meal and the fish-based fertilizers kept them green and growing. Soon I'll be applying a more balanced fertilizer. I haven't done that yet. I want to make sure my vines are good and strong. Once they get about 6 feet, a little bit longer, they can handle some large fruits. And I have quite a few little buds here. Here's a nice female bud starting with a little cluster of males. So if the weather cooperates and I can get some good fertilizer on these, some good balanced fertilizer, I should be able to get some kind of crop this year, even though they are a little bit behind. They are catching up. It's the 17th of July. The plants are getting some good growth in. Getting my first fruits of the season. And a few flowers still coming on. there's another little one. And I go down the vine. And here's another little one. Been giving them a lot of fertilizer here lately. Good amounts of all-purpose fertilizer. Trying to stimulate more bud growth. Get some more luffas growing. It's the 24th of July. The sunflowers have done really well this year. The weather has been very hot lately, which is what the luffa vine's like. There's a male flower. And they continue to grow, quite a few of them, about 10 feet long. And getting some nice little fruits growing on them. Well, things hold out. I get a good rain now and then. The weather stays hot. They might do fairly well. Here's this one luffa pod I've been watching, and it's about ready to be peeled. It's not very large, but it's dry. It's getting a little crunchy here. So I'll probably peel this sometime in the next couple days. I'm getting some more nice fruit starting. It's getting really late in the season. The morning glories are trying to take over. Here's a small one hanging down here. It's the 18th of September. Everything's still growing well. It's been very hot. Over 60 days above 90 degrees this summer. We usually have about 20. The vines continue to bloom. Producing flowers, buds. Had to water them several times this month. It's just been so dry. There's a couple decent luffas. This one's pretty big, actually. The smaller one here is ready to be peeled. Yeah, that's ready to come right off of there. I'll peel that today. The bottom's breaking out of it. This is one I peeled the other day. It was hanging here like this. I just peeled the skin off. I've peeled three so far this year. They've not been very large. I have a lot of spots on them. But the quality of this fiber is really good. So the vine's continuing to grow. It's October 4. The weather's been nice and warm. We've gotten some good rains. And here's a luffa that's actually a day or two past ready to pick. Still has a little moisture in there. I'll crack it open here and peel it today. It's October 16th. No frost yet, which is good. It's been fairly warm. My surviving vines are still growing. still producing. I'm hoping the frost will hold off till November sometime. It's been such a warm year, it may actually do that. And as I go on down the vines, here's one that's almost ready to be picked. It's turning a lighter color. It feels lighter. Some of the vines are starting to die from old age. It's still very dry. This has been an extremely dry year. It's caused me to have a very low yield. The hot weather was good, but we're still about 5 inches below normal for rainfall. It's really been hard on the vines. Going down the fence here. Starting to get some fall colors in the trees. Probably won't have very good color this year because the weather was so dry. Not as many leaves. And this thing here is just sprouting like crazy. Three female buds, one node here. That's quite a few. And here's another one hanging here. So I guess that's all I got for now. It's November 4th. Still no frost. Much later than usual. We may get some frost this weekend though, which is, since this is Friday, we have some frost by tomorrow, according to the weather reports. So this may be the last segment I do on this year's video. This here's probably still my nicest one. It's almost ready. Really could use a couple more days, but some of the vines are still hanging on. It's still really dry. We are 7 inches low on rain this year. It's very, very dry. Having some forest fires in the area. Well, now here's one hanging on the other side of the fence that I have missed. It's ready to be peeled. The sound of it sounds hollow. I'll have to pull that off and peel that today. Well, it's been a tough year. I'm going to get a few more of these with some fiber. I'll probably have some green ones here I'll have to peel. So I guess I'll stop here for now. And hopefully next year we'll have a little more rain. I may even have to put in some irrigation. Here is a volunteer vine that grew up on the ground, on gravel, where some seeds must have fell last year. It's November 6th, and it still is not frosted. This thing is still hanging on to life. I don't think it sprouted till about August. Resilient vines, if they have enough warmth and water. It's November 6th. We dodged the frost bullet again. Thought for sure it'd frost this weekend. Still looks about the same as the other day. The vines here on the garden trellis are still hanging on. There's a little strange one I need to pull off and peel. Here's one that's almost ready. The skin's getting little bit loose and soft. It's turning brown so far. Brown is good. I've had a couple that rotted from the bottom this year. Brown is good and black is not. And these vines are still producing. These are just way too late. Our frost held off from freezing anything. But the vines are so far behind from the drought this year. A lot of them didn't even survive. I have picked a few nice ones. I probably won't get a lot this year. This is the last one I picked. It's pretty nice, but it's not as large. Usually my larger ones will be half again as big as this one. Well, that's all I got for now. It's November 11th. We finally had our first real frost about 3 weeks later than usual, which would have been great if I'd had enough rain to grow some good vines. It was so dry this year. Looks like the season's at an end. My vines are pretty well wiped out now. I've got to pick and peel the rest of my luffa pods hanging out here. Most of them are nearly mature thanks to the longer season. That's what I'll be doing today. Well, thanks for watching. It's been a rather trying season. Here are the results of the last day of luffa harvesting. These were all picked after the frost killed the vines. Most of them were nearly ready to be picked anyway. Just not a lot this year, not very large. Still some nice fiber though.